Big data clusters provide a way of keeping the cluster reliable by enabling high availability for the critical components, and Mihaela is here to tell us all about it today on Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm your host, Jeroen, and today we have Mihaela with us to talk about big data clusters and specifically the high availability for them. So welcome back. This must be the third time, I think.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for having me here.
Yeah, you're becoming a pro. So, you know, most of the topics you talk about is big data clusters, and today is no different. But then high availability, right?
Yeah, so there are a lot of things to talk about when it comes to high availability.
Okay.
And we're going to go through some of those aspects in this video now.
Okay, cool. Yeah, let's get started.
So when we talk about data, right, especially and databases, right, we want to make sure that data is persisted. So mm-hmm. I just want to start with this high availability talk with the storage recap.
Okay.
So different layers in the big data cluster have different options for storage. Either you can do a local storage or remote.
Mm-hmm.
And we made it as granular as you can opt in for local or remote, depending if you want to store data or the logs, right? So logs, you don't want necessarily to make it redundant. So because there you might need it for troubleshooting, but then mm-hmm. you don't want to keep them forever, right?
It's less valuable than
exactly. So when we talk to about logs, it's mostly, you know, you want to keep them on a local storage, especially because we were talking in the last video that we have components in the clusters that are collecting those logs and are storing them in Elasticsearch. So you already have some redundancy on that aspect.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to data, various components have different requirements. Depending on how mission critical are and if there is any user data that is stored in for that, like for example SQL Server master or storage pool, like where HDFS data is kept, you do want to maintain redundancy for that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But compute pool or Spark, right, there is no state,
nope.
Right, is just compute, so there is no point to add additional redundancy to the
right.
storage.
Exactly. So there you can choose local.
So we're talking here about some different options that you have to ensure the reliability of those services when it comes to data persistence.
Okay.
And that's where we continue with the HA options, right?
Mm-hmm.
So for SQL Server Master, if you're storing your data locally, you must ensure that you're adding some additional redundancy to that with availability groups. And we're going to see shortly how is that enabled. When it comes to data pool, you use PVs,
yeah.
right, in Kubernetes to ensure the data is persisted.
So just PVs, right? There's a lot of acronyms here.
Yeah.
You know, AG, PV, HA, everything. PV is...
So just PVs is a Kubernetes concept that abstracts the storage layer of Kubernetes
okay.
and ensures if you're using persistent volumes, so the notion is, you know, data
volume.
Persistence, right? So if you're using persistent volumes, it means that Kubernetes ensures the data is persisted on
okay.
that storage.
Got it.
Again, there is no need to ensure high availability for compute because it's stateless. We have critical components in the Hadoop stack, right, when it comes to HDFS name node and some Spark shared services that you need to enable high availability for. And very, very important, I want to highlight here the control,
mm-hmm.
the service that you must have not only persistent volumes, but you need to add some redundancy to that storage. So it has to be some remote redundant storage. Don't keep your control metadata locally
okay.
because if that node is lost, your pretty much entire cluster is not in a very good shape.
Okay. So control
yes.
will have PVs on a remote storage.
Remote and redundant. So you have
okay.
to make sure that you add some redundancy to that layer.
Okay. Noted.
So now let's see what that means for SQL Server Master and enabling AGs for that. So this is a schema of how the layout of various services that form the SQL Server high availability layer for SQL Server Master. Mm-hmm. Again, we have a primary with at least two secondaries, right? Synchronous.
Okay.
And we have we build components that are ensuring that there is automatic monitoring, automatic failover, and the orchestration. If something happens with the primary, it happens automatically. There is no need to do anything.
Mm-hmm.
One thing that I want to highlight here is that for Big Data cluster only at this time, we also enable what we call a contain availability group, which means that now objects that you store in master, for example, like logins,
mm-hmm.
Are also replicated to the secondaries. Right.
Okay.
So until now, there is no, like, this is a long outstanding ask from our customers to make sure that logins are also replicated. Otherwise, there is a lot of orchestration and manual replication they had to do. Right now, automatically, everything is taken care of. So from deployment, from adding databases to the availability groups, to adding this master replicated database mm-hmm. to the availability group. So there is little, if none, almost
wow.
management of operational management of the availability group.
That's
pretty awesome.
Yeah, that's real awesome, I was going to say. So, but you mentioned availability groups
yeah.
now, right? Is that kind of like, is that the regular?
Yeah, it is exactly
thing?
The same feature that we all know from SQL Server 2012, right?
Yeah.
One thing that it's very, very important, there is no other cluster technology that you're going to have to deploy
right.
or integrate
mm-hmm.
with. It's everything taken care of, the services that we're deploying with the HA supervisor, the operator, and of course, tightly integrating with Kubernetes
right.
in this case.
So
because we are taking advantage of this platform.
So no more cluster technology. So this is great for the master instance, right? So now I trust the master instance is fine. But there's more in the BDC, right? We're not only doing like a SQL
yeah.
Server, we're doing, you know, the Hadoop related stuff. So
let's see what we're doing for Hadoop, right?
Yeah.
For HDFS. So
mm-hmm.
HDFS name node is must also be, you know, in a highly available configuration because that's critical for the Hadoop stack. And what we're doing there, you know, when customer is telling us, oh, I want replication for name node, we're also deploying Zookeeper, which
okay.
is an open source cluster technology.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the component that is going to take care of coordinating the monitoring and the failover, if needed, of the name node to a standby secondary, right?
Okay.
So we're deploying an additional replica and Zookeeper is taking care of the orchestration aspect.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. In the same time is also involved in maintaining high availability for some Spark share components like Yarn Resource Manager.
Right.
And in that sense for Spark, we also deploy multiple replicas for services like Spark History, Job History, so to make sure that if something is going on in with one node that these services are hosted, that the load will be picked up for the additional replicas.
Cool.
So let's see how easy it is to configure the high availability for these various components.
Tell me it's easy.
It is super easy.
Cool. I like easy.
We talked last time about how to configure your deployment,
yes, I
right?
remember that.
And
yep.
there is the cluster configuration files
mm-hmm.
or the deployment templates that you have. And remember, we were talking earlier about the Spark share components, right?
Yeah.
I just want two replicas of them, right? And that's it. We take care of picking up from there.
Is that all?
Zookeeper. So again, we have to go through all the components that we
sure.
ran through. Zookeeper, we're going to need three replicas to
mm-hmm.
ensure quorum.
Mm-hmm.
And then we also mentioned master,
mm-hmm.
like SQL Server master instance. And what do I do here? I just say that I want three replicas, right? And because SQL Server availability groups also enables readable secondaries, we'll give you the option to deploy a service that is exposing an endpoint to do read-only workload from the secondary, and you just have to specify the port here in this case.
Right. So that's you know, you do the high availability, and as part of that, you could also do the read-only offloading.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah.
Cool. And is that how easy it is? Just this one line and everything?
Yeah, you just specify how many replicas. You don't worry about, you know, orchestrating, deploying additional components. Like when you tell us that I want three replicas for SQL Server Master, we deploy the operator, we deploy the supervisor that is doing the monitoring and everything else.
Happens.
So that's everything is behind the scenes, and there is minimal orchestration for setting things up. I don't, for folks that are very familiar with how to deploy an availability, how to configure an availability group, I think it's at least 4 or 5 T-SQL statements plus, you know, prepping endpoints and things like that. So that's pretty awesome.
Yeah,
we're taking that load from you to focus on actually running workloads on the big data.
I mean, it doesn't get more simple than this, right?
It is one
line, and then of course with the master instance, if you want more lines for the read-onlys. But yeah, that's really impressive. So cool. So where can I find more about this? How do I get started? Can you point me to some documentation or blogs?
So definitely, I'll show you exactly some links that you can leverage to for the deployment, for the configuration. So you can find here more about it in our documentation platform. But we also have a lot of samples out there on how to configure things, how to run workloads, and everything is. You can go ahead to use these links and leverage them for whatever you want to do with big data clusters.
Cool. Well, thanks again for sharing and talking us through this. This was very impressive.
Oh.
I like the easiness of creating this.
It's clearly
a lot of work went into
awesome,
this.
Pretty awesome. Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, thanks, and thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment, and hope to see you next time. Thanks.